When we examine the religion of Islam after the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, before he left, in a famous statement that all Muslims have recorded, he said, "I leave after me the Book of Allah and my Ahlul Bayt." These are the source of salvation, the source of guidance. If you hold on to them, you will never go astray. But what happened after the Prophet was something very tragic. And this is a common theme that we've been discussing, you know, when it comes to the history of the Hadith, the history of Islamic law, is that after the Prophet, there were two main challenges. The first challenge was that there was a ban that was imposed on the recording of Hadith, the prohibition of recording the Hadith. This lasted for 100 years. Until the time of one of the final and last Umayyad rulers and kings, Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz. He is the one who lifted this ban temporarily. Of course, we had an exception of 4 years during the time of Imam Ali alayhi salam, in which he also lifted the ban and he encouraged the people of his time, and he had scribes who would write and document the Hadith. But for 100 years, there was a ban on the recording of the Hadith. You can imagine what happened to the Muslim Ummah at the time. This is something that history documents. Those caliphs who came after the Prophet, they imposed a ban. They gathered the Hadiths that they found and they burned them. This is not some, you know, Shia source that's claiming this. No, this is our history. I'm referring to Sunni sources here. The first Khalifa, Abu Bakr, when he rose to power, one of the first things that he did is that he had recorded 500 hadiths, he set them to fire. Now their justification was that we don't want people to be busy with hadith and to abandon the Quran. Now this was their excuse. But for 100 years there was a ban. The beliefs of the people changed. The new generation of Muslims, they had no clue what Islam was about. Yes, the Quran was there. It's the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the Quran, is it enough that you just give it to someone without any explanation, any tafsir, any hadith? The Prophet, throughout a period of 23 years, he explained what the Quran is. You can't just isolate that. So there was a ban that lasted for about 100 years. This was a challenge that plagued the Muslim Ummah. And it had very drastic consequences on the belief system of the people. That's why you found decades after the Prophet, the people's beliefs had changed. Most people did not have a firm belief in the religion of Islam. They did not understand Islam. And hence you have a hadith that says after Al-Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam was martyred at Karbala. Now this is, I know, a very scary hadith. But it says that there were only 3 true Muslims who supported Al-Imam Zayn al-Abidin. Only 3. Out of this entire Muslim Ummah, only 3. Can you imagine?